What's up, guys? So this is our second interview. Shit, I don't remember how I started the last one, but
Black Atlas Radio.
Black Atlas Media. Subscribe.
With our guest Opine here.
Yes, what happened with y'all?
Go ahead and tell us a little bit about yourself.
The name's Opine is my name. The full aspect, you can call me Opine, whatever. I really don't care. It's just I had to. For legal issues, I made my name Opine is my name.
Oh, really? Oh, is shit. That where that came in?
Is someone taking Opine?
Yeah, it's like a metal band named Opine.
That's and I was like, weird.
I found out there's another Black Atlas Media.
Yeah, like
exactly the same shit.
We
too.
Have to say some other shit.
But I mean, they're like their account is the shit is old. So
okay.
So yeah, so as far as my shit, I just I already had a hashtag name, Opine is my name, so I just ended up changing it completely, making it Opine is my name, because I didn't feel like dealing with none of that bullshit. I just wanted to do what I had to do.
Be safe.
Yeah.
It's cool,
man. It has a nice ring to it.
Yeah, so, but yeah, that's it.
What does Opine mean? Does that mean?
Opine is actually a synonym, technically a synonym for think, and it means to express one's opinions openly without hesitation or fear. It was, like, one of the main things, like, because when I started rapping, I was, like, I wanted, like, make people think. Like, that was a thing I wanted people to do, like, just kind of think differently. So, I looked up synonyms for think, and Opine was one of them, and I was, like, the hell is that?
So sounds cool. It's cool. I think that's all that matters.
So cool.
If your shit sounds catchy.
Exactly. If shit sounds catchy, catch on to every other thing.
Exactly. So, I was just, like, look, let me drop that. And that's how it went from there on.
Nice. So, with, you're an artist, of course.
Yes.
So, do you like, what do you prefer to do? Because we listen to music, and do you like to sing more, or do you like to rap more?
It's funny, because when I was younger, I was a straight, I was a singer. I didn't mess with, like, hip-hop at all. Not as in, like, a bad way. It was just, like, the connotation that everything was given. I grew up in, like, a really Christian home, so it was kind of like, I was, like, off limits, hip hop, bad. Like,
you hit the vocals.
Yeah. So then I was singing in church and stuff like that. Yeah. And then it's really funny, like Kanye was the first like hip hop album. The College Dropout was the first hip hop album I ever bought or ever had.
Mine was Graduation.
I was 808s.
So yeah, so Kanye, shout out to him, you know he going through some things. It's good, but
he
on some other
shit right now. Right now, shit.
But I mean, you know, you know, get out. But anyway, but yeah, he's just ever since then, I've really like he's the first person that made me pay attention to hip hop, and then Kendrick really made me fall in love with hip hop with Good Kid, M.A.A.D City. So
I feel like Good Kid, M.A.A.D City is definitely my
shit
favorite Kendrick album.
Yeah.
Shit is legendary.
Yeah, definitely fuck with that.
Exactly. So,
any other artists that have influenced you or made you think?
Influenced altogether? Like, I try to tell people I want to be like a cross between Kendrick and Prince, like if they had a kid.
Ooh, that's crazy.
That would be me.
Ooh, that's what's up.
Like,
you gotta get this the fashion sense too.
Yeah, the fashion. I'm trying to work on it. I'm working on it a little bit.
Some it's bright ass neon colors.
It's kind of hard because, you know, it's like I don't want to do too much because I'm really like hella laid back. I don't really fuck with like name brands and stuff like that.
Okay.
Like, I'm not really a huge dude on name brands. If I see it and I like it, I'll buy it. But
yeah, if the shit looks nice, I feel like that's all that matters.
Exactly. If it looks good, I'll buy it. But as far as just like trying too hard to impress people, I'm really not like that.
You don't got a bunch of pairs of True Religions.
Hell no.
I don't own a true.
I don't
own a pair of fucking shoes. Don't have a pair of trues and own a car.
Bro, me and my shorty
and not have a car.
Bro, me and my shorty went in a true like yesterday. And at the Art of Mall, and she seen the jacket, and I was like, hey, that's wet. And she looked at it, like, $300. Like,
hella expensive. That's like a paycheck. Dude, like,
fuck that.
Shit. I was like, I gotta be fucked up. I am not finna pay no $300 for a jean jacket that looked like it was painted on. I might as well give it to an artist out here that could paint some shit, and it'd be like, there, rock it. Like,
probably look like 10 times better.
Dope, man.
So, what would you say? We kind of have, like, an idea of what your style of music is, but what is your favorite kind of music? You mentioned, like, Kanye and Prince as being influences, but, like, what's some shit you listen to, like, right now? Like, if you, like, just shuffled your whole library.
Right now, I've been listening to a lot of that Suns Triad, Tyrate, Isaiah Rashad. I heard y'all went to the
last
weekend.
Night.
That was lit.
I'm hella jealous because I wanted to go, but I couldn't, but it's good. But, yeah, Isaiah Rashad is definitely somebody I've been listening to lately. I've been listening to a lot of older stuff. Like yesterday, since Biggie had died, was killed yesterday. I was listening to the.
Hell yeah! Rest in peace.
Yeah, I listened to that album. I was just listening to All Eyes on Me on the way here, the whole album. So I had that. I'm a CD copy dude too. Like I buy hard copies.
How old are you?
I'm 21.
Oh, 21.
So, yeah, so I buy hard copies of shit, so I have like actual hard copies of these albums. Like,
yeah, I'm a vinyl poser. So.
See, I wanna be one. I really wanna have vinyls and stuff like that. I don't have a vinyl player yet.
I realized I had to get the vinyl player.
He got his like after he already started buying.
He was already starting your shit. Yep. Yeah. I just get albums. I love having albums and shit. So it's like it's nothing. Like opening an album, looking in the booklet, and being shit.
Getting
like,
extra shit that comes with it.
I get
a
rush from that shit, like it ain't nothing. So
I feel the same way about like games and movies and shit. Like everything's all like on a digital market for you to buy, but I'd rather just go and get the shit like physically to hold in my hand.
I was a gamer for like 2 months, and I realized I was too lazy, and I didn't care that much to finish the game all the way through.
That's my problem now. I have that same exact problem right now. I just buy shit, and then I just leave it. Man. I'm too lazy to play.
I'll be like, I'll play the storyline, and after that, I'm like, okay, I can do all of these challenges that they have on the side, or I can get another game and have a whole brand new thing to do. Like, I'll do that.
That's what's up.
So, as far as, like, the music scene in Fairfield goes, we know, like, a couple of people here and there, but I'm sure you probably have, like, you probably know more people than us. Who would you say, like, your favorite local artist is
locally,
so far?
Like, out here in Fairfield? I was supposed to say, like, Bay Area-wise right now, a lot of T-Carry and a lot of Collaborate, because I'm watching them, like, it's like watching your big brothers graduate high school. It's kind of like, wow, they're getting there, so I'm, like, next up, hopefully.
Right.
As far as...
He's verified on Twitter.
That's verified. You're trying to get verified,
too. Yeah. I was like, man, I'm trying to get verified. And then he quoted that shit. It was just like, don't worry about getting verified, bro. Just do what you got to do. It's good. And I was like, all right, for sure.
So as far as people in Fairfield.
Let's see, because we got our own little mini diaspora out here if we really think about it.
You guys do have a little clique in a way, outside the clique, like who else have you noticed?
That I've noticed outside the clique. So like outside of Tribe and outside of like Spills and Raycel, I would talk about. I've been watching Young Lodge do what he does.
Right.
I've been watching like his older brother. I watched him before, like when he dropped Higher Learning 2. I used to listen to that for a minute. Other than that, I've really just been really paying attention to like people that haven't even put nothing out. You know, just people that's come to me and been like, hey, I like this. Do you think this is cool? How would you think? And that's pretty much how it's really been going. Because as far as out here, not too many people, like, I don't know, I feel like not many people really fuck with me like that out here.
That's actually going into my next question, which was, like, have there been people, like, trying to reach out to you to, like, do collabs with you and stuff?
I've had people do collabs, like, if you know, y'all heard of YT, the dude now, YT? He's out here, he was, like, older than us for a minute, though, so I don't even know, but he was out here, they had me sing on one of his songs called Solid, and it was cool, but then it's like, they forgot to put my name as a feature, and then, not only that, they, like, cut a lot of my vocals that I sang on out of it, so it's kind of like,
that's fucked up.
It kind of, like, they kind of fucked it up as far as, like, me collaborating with people that, if I don't really know you, I'm like, cool, we could do that, but I gotta watch how your effort is.
Yeah,
like,
did they pay you?
Nah, they didn't pay. It was just, it was like, I came in that day for a feature for Smooth, and it was cool. Like, I did my verse, and he was like, I didn't know you could sing too. Hey, you wanna sing on this? I was like, for sure. And that's just how it went down. It wasn't
right.
like,
it
I was
a,
like, you gotta
a contract.
Yeah, it was just like,
let's just get it on.
So that's cool. Just how kind of how it happened. But it's no hard feelings or nothing. It's just kind of like, now I really be skeptical about who I watch. Other than that, I got another artist that I work with him at Lowe's. His name Gip, Lil Gip. You haven't heard of him, but
I heard of Gip.
He's been watching him too.
going into more questions about you personally. So, like, what's your library looking like right now? Like, your current projects that you have, are they, like, on SoundCloud?
Yeah, I have... Altogether, I have, like, three, like, projects done. The first one was, like, when I really first started rapping, and, like, I started rapping around, like, 2013, I think it was. Like, actually, like, seriously pursuing it. Nice. And it was when I was, like, because I've always written songs like that. Like I said, I wasn't a hip-hop artist or a rapper. I didn't do rap at all. Right, so it was kind of like, I wrote poems and I wrote stuff to sing, but it was never like, I'm going to do this, you know?
Like as a career.
Yeah. So when it came down to really starting it, my first like mixtape was Giant Slayer. And oh my gosh, that shit.
That sounds cool. That's cool.
It was dope as far as like the concept of it, but like I was like really like deep into... a Christian faith at that moment in time in my life, because I was just watching a lot of negative things, and I was like, y'all doing all this, I could do it, and I'm gonna rap about Jesus Christ and see what y'all gonna do about and see how y'all gonna say it. But it was pretty cool. Like I just remixed a whole bunch of different songs and just threw it on the tape. It received well with like my family and stuff, but when I finally started doing this for me and doing what I wanted to do, it was kind of like I did a EP called Identity Crisis, and
was I don't know. Is that the one with the mask?
Mm-hmm. Oh,
okay.
Not even that one. That one was Mount Horeb. That one's a different one. That's the one with the mask. But the one before it was one called Identity Crisis. Those two are on DatPiff. I don't have it anywhere else. It's just on DatPiff.
Oh, okay.
you want to find that? Just go on DatPiff and search Opine, and I'll pop.
I'll put all the shit in the description box.
But yeah, I did the Identity Crisis. On that one, there's five songs. I made every beat from this thing called Loop Labs. And it was kind of dope.
Free loops.
Somewhat. It was just like, they give you these stock little things, loops that you could just mix together. So I did that, and then I just dropped it. It was more of a cry for help, because I was going through a lot of like depression shit at that moment in time. So me releasing it helped me a whole lot.
It's usually when like the best music is made, people are going through some shit.
Yeah, so me releasing it it helped me release myself. And it finally was like, this is what I want to do. This is where I was doing. So, like, when I dropped that, that's when I was really, like, serious of, like, for sure, like, I'm going to pursue this and hopefully make it.
So, what's your process in making music? Do you write it down first and then hear the beat? Or do you hear the beat and then you write going off of that?
It really depends. Like, me, I can write and then I'll be like, all right, this is a song. I'm going to go to my producer and we'll work together to make a beat.
Make it work with the... Yeah.
Like with the Mount Horeb, the most recent one, I had a bunch of them where I had already written, and then a bunch of them where it was just beats that came and I was like, oh, I'm gonna write to this.
Nice.
Like Lost, the one that everybody loves, like I wrote that before there was any beat at all.
Okay.
And then my friend literally dropped a beat on SoundCloud, Bishop J, and I was tripping because I was like, nigga, this fits perfectly.
That's great.
And I was like, how the hell did this fit so great? Yeah. So ever since then, it's just, that's really pretty much my creative process. And with working a full-time job, it's kind of difficult. So it's like, you'll find me at work, like, just spitting random bars, hopefully, and then I come together.
Through
like,
the intercom.
Like, yeah. The intercom.
While people shopping.
But yeah, putting up some pots, like, this, that, together. And it all comes together somehow, some way, so...
So, hopefully working a full-time job, when do you find time? It's like, you have to go in the middle? Do you wake nights, or do you early?
I work constantly, basically. It's a constant process. Like, I used to wake up every morning and write at least, like, four lines, at least.
Okay.
Or I'll go at work. During my breaks, I'll write something. Or even during work. Hood Rat, that shit, I wrote that while at work, like literally putting shit together, like, man, I don't want to do some hood rat shit with my niggas. Like, that's literally how it came. That's literally how it became a song. I was like, I don't want to do hood rat shit with my niggas. Goddamn. So ever since I had to force myself to be creative at all times, it's just been a little bit easier. I may have a little funk every now and then, but for the most part, I can write whenever, wherever, for the most part.
So what would you say is like your, out of all of your work that you have so far, what's like your personal favorite? you're most proud of?
Most proud of? My most proud of stuff isn't even dropped yet. Like, that's what I was like. I have a couple songs, like, Homicide, I really loved, like, the whole idea of the song. It was really, because it was written for just a bunch of everybody that pretty much died along my process of becoming an artist. So it was like Meech and Tasia and all of them, just everybody that was just taking Ricky, like taking too soon that they shouldn't have been taking so soon. Like, it was really a dedication to them. So as far as that goes, that's one of my favorites. It'll always be hold dear to my heart. But as far as songs that I have really coming, yeah, like I have this song called Yenim. It's money spelled backwards.
Stay tuned.
That's one I
got a real
Isaiah Rashad feel too, so I hope y'all like it when it really drops.
So
retweeting
and shit.
So
look for us.
It's lit.
So we can go ahead and assume that you have some shit in the works.
I really have an album I wanted to drop earlier this year, like late winter, but because Bishop J, my man, he kind of like disappeared on everybody. Like, I don't know how it happened. Like, I don't know. It was just like, we was working. We had all of these things going on. We had all these plans to, like, record. And then stuff came up, and I understood. But then all of a sudden, he fell off the face of the earth for, like, 3 months. And it's like, what?
Fine, Bishop J.
I mean, he came back, though. So he came back. Because that's how I ended up getting my beats back. But, like, it's just now I'm looking for somebody that I could work with that's not going to,
like, more reliable.
I got an album coming. Hopefully I could drop it this winter. It's called Days Winter Blooms, if you haven't been watching me talk about it.
Okay.
So hopefully it comes out in the winter, so it kind of makes a little bit more sense.
I feel it. How many tracks do you think you'd want to have on this so far?
I just mapped it out a couple of days ago as far as how I wanted to go. And all together it's probably going to be 12 tracks, if not maybe a couple more, just because of like skits and stuff like that in between, because I like making movies. Like, that's why I love Good Kid, Mad City so much. Like, I could listen to that album in the dark and literally watch a movie on my roof if I wanted to.
So you like albums with like concepts and stuff.
I love concept,
like storytelling and shit like that.
The whole thing where everything works together. That's why a lot of people didn't really get, like, I showed some people Hood Rat, and I was like, I like it, but that's not you. And I was like, there's a reason for it. So it's like,
it's cohesive and works together.
Everything works together, but they don't know yet. So once it all drops, then they'll be like, I get it.
That's going to be great.
Have you been doing any performances?
I just recently did Words. It's been a minute since I was at Words. It was really because I wanted to do new shit. And because of the fact that people was disappeared and all of this stuff, I didn't have beats to perform just new shit. Like, I don't like performing with my track, like, actually playing. Like, if I'm performing, it has to be the background vocals, and then I'm rapping the actual lyrics. Like, I don't want to be up there rapping. It's like singing along to a song. I might as well just go to a club and do that shit. So
it's more like genuine.
Yeah, I really can put it together. Plus, if I wanted to, like, do something a little different or tweak it, like, because, like I said, Kendrick Lamar is one of my biggest influences. When I watch him perform, it's over. Like, I literally, like, I cut everybody off. Chill. Let me watch this. I watch it first. Tear up a little bit. Oh, my God, this is dope. Then after that, I watch it again and take notes on what I like and what I didn't like and what I want to do and what I changed. That's why I watch performances all the time. Like, the Grammys. I watch the Grammys literally just to watch performances to see what I didn't like and what I did like. So. Right.
So what type of energy do you bring to stage? Like, for songs, are you like a hyped up dude? Or like jumping around stuff? Or are you just like chilling?
Depends on the
song. Vibing with the crowd.
It depends on, I channel what I wrote, like, I channel what I was feeling when I was writing the song or when I was performing the song on the mic. So however I envisioned it to be on the mic and to come through for the listener, that's how I perform it.
There's like a lot of people who go to concerts and they like hype up the crowd as much as they could, but like the concert we went to, the Isaiah Rashad concert we went to last night, there was a lot of like majority of the entire concert was like chill as fuck. It was like people weren't really jumping up and down. It was just like him doing his, like, his vibing shit and singing or whatever, and everybody else was just, like, chilling in the crowd.
Yeah, and that's what I really like, I like to do. I'm here to entertain. Like, I love the idea of y'all hype, being hyped up and everything. That's great. But, like, a lot of people live through that with their phones rather than just being there, sitting there, and being entertained and, like, being able to just be like, wow, I'm amazed. So that's what
being in the moment.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So that's why I really, like, want, as far as when I started really doing tours and shows and stuff like that, I want people to really just be able to be there and just sit there and just be like, wow, you know?
Nice.
So I want them to have a refresh. Like it's like watching it on your TV. Like, literally, I want you to be there and just be like, I don't have to record nothing. I don't have to do nothing. I can just sit here and enjoy the show.
Right. So for booking shows, so you're waiting to get new stuff to book shows?
Now that what was happening literally was the music, my beats were basically, in a sense, being held captive.
Right.
So once I finally got them, I was like, okay, now I can really, like, go. That's why I ended up doing words recently, because I was like, I have my music, I can do this now. So now I'm really just working on getting stuff recorded, but in between, I'm starting to line up shows just now, like, literally before I got here. That's why I was kind of late, because I was like, I'm going to line up some shows here, line up some shows there. I was trying to go to New York in April so I could go to some open mics and do something.
Ooh, that's crazy.
But it's going to fall through because I'm moving, so I ain't got enough.
We don't got, we don't got any open mics around here.
Oh, yeah, so that's why I was like, I got some open mics just literally hit to my phone, like, 5 minutes before I got here.
Okay.
So that's why I'm like, I'm going to work through those and see when I can schedule to get there. And hopefully it's going to be working.
Yeah, I definitely didn't put a timer on.
It's okay.
Anyways, so your thoughts on Fairfield as a city, as a community? Like, if you could say something to the population of Fairfield as a whole and, like, get a message out there, what would you say?
When I first came here around, like, 6 or 7 years old after my parents split, I hated it here. Not because of anything other than it just felt like I was in a cage. And even now, to this day, I still feel like I'm in a cage while I'm here. I feel like this is a place where a lot of old people come to, like, stay away from the shenanigans.
Yeah.
But because of gentrification and all that shit going on in Oakland, a lot of people got forced to come this way. So, but as far as Fairfield goes, I still have love for this place. This is where I became who I am. So I love it here. I was born in, like, I tell people I'm not from here. I was born in San Diego, and it's like I never really fit in the Bay, if that makes sense. Like, I'm from here, but it just never seemed like I fit here. And I was only in San Diego for like 2 years. I was here, I was there, born there, left at 2 years old. But it's just, I never fit here. Right. I can blend well, and I can do, like, I can make it seem like I'm from here, but I'm really not from here.
There's a different vibe to Bay Area people.
Yeah, and
especially,
it's
like, when you get real into the Bay.
Yeah, and it's like nothing, like, it's nothing, it's nothing bad about it at all. I love it and everything. It's just, like, I just feel like I'm not as authentic Bay Area person.
I don't know. As an authentic Bay Area person is a person who is still living off the hyphy movement.
Somewhat true.
Like, we gotta find our new wave of movement
because
people and things.
It's trash too, because it's a lot of that is appropriated in the mainstream, like, especially nowadays. It's like, I was just, when I was watching Spiller's interview, I was telling my girl while I was watching, I was like, the Bay Area is like the black people of the music industry. Like,
hell yeah.
Our shit is appropriated, but nobody really wants to be Bay.
And no one really wants to listen to us either,
exactly,
other than us.
Exactly.
Like,
exactly.
We support our own people.
Like,
it's what we're here for.
let's get the fuck out of here.
Get the message going.
Yeah,
spread the movement.
That's what that was about. And then, but as far as Fairfield goes, I love it here. I just love the fact that I'm from here, because I see it as more of an opportunity than it is, like, a drag. I see it as an opportunity to really, like, make change. Like, I got a lot of plans to, like, really fix this place up if I get to where I'm willing to get to.
Right.
Opine for mayor. 2017.
Come back and support. Do whatever we can to make this city better.
Like that Kmart over there before it was a Planet Fitness. Before
that Kmart, man.
Yeah,
that
before Kmart. It was a Planet Fitness, I was like, man, I'm going to turn that into a rec center and it's going to be lit. And then,
oh, shit.
But then they, you know.
Made it to a Planet Fitness.
But it's all good, man. Like I said, it's just, I have a lot of plans to, like, really fix up this area. So I want to, like, get where I'm going, come back, fix home first, and then start venturing out just for, like, just my people. Right.
Invest, make some business decisions.
That's good. At least you say you're willing to like give back to the community, not looking at you, Sage. But
definitely, he's definitely told us he's not giving a fuck about us. So.
I can't really be too mad at him for it just because he did get picked on a lot when he was younger, apparently. So, I get that.
I wouldn't know.
I wouldn't know either.
Is it at the same time?
I hope he doesn't. Like, I hope you're okay.
But, I mean, at the same time, though, it's like, that's the thing, though. You're supposed to use that type of, like.
Platform.
Yeah, so people don't have to go through that, you know? You can't just, like, make it big.
You gotta put us on the map so we can put other people on the map.
But, yeah, but you know, nowadays, it doesn't matter. People are just assholes.
It's good.
So, I mean, when it comes to that whole Sage situation, I remember, like, when he first got famous for a minute.
That gas pedal?
Yeah, and Josh was going off on him on Twitter.
Josh.
Original OJ. Original Josh.
Josh.
Like, Josh. Though he used to be rapping.
Hawaii.
Yes. Oh. Josh.
Who's that?
He dated
Ariana.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I already knew. He was going off on him on Twitter, and I was weak as shit. And then this nigga came at me sideways, and I was like, What?
Josh or Sage?
No, Sage came at me sideways. He was like, you over here. He was like, how old are you? At the time, I was like 17. I was like, I'm like 17, bro. He thought I was like 21. I was like, nah, nigga, I'm 17.
Hold on.
I'm still in high school, bro. Sure. He was just like, yeah, it's cool, but y'all doing all of this, talking all this stuff, don't even realize I've been writing with niggas like Trey Songz and shit like that. And I was like, okay, I'm not knocking you for making it out, but we're over here like, trying to understand why you making it out and not giving niggas no love at all. You feel me? Like, and it's not even like you could give us love and say like I'm from Fairfield on an interview. Like that's cool and all, but like niggas, we got fucking one fucking middle school, bro. Like one middle school, not two. Crystal and Drains. Like we got two middle schools.
I know you don't got the guap like that yet, Sage. But get back to something.
You got a fat ass house. Create a studio. Up in like Rancho Solano.
Create a studio out here for these young local artists. Man. Create something where we can do some shit for the free and we can help out people.
Like, I was just saying, like,
making money like that.
And I can understand the conflict with it because a lot of the times you give niggas something and they just fuck it up all the time. But
definitely. That's
not all the time. Like, you just gotta, at some point, you gotta have faith in the place where you came from and the place that you, like, with the people that you're around. So, I mean, that's what I'm gonna do. So, once I get there, hopefully,
would you do a collab with Sage?
What I do, I mean, I would, but I honestly don't think we have anything to really talk about at the same time. It's kind of like how Kendrick was like, I'm not really finna do too many more collabs with Drake because it's like we're not on the same page.
Definitely
we're both
not.
On different pages, like, and it's nothing against Sage because he's got a lot of stuff like that shit with Trey Songz, Guantanamo. That was my shit. I used to love that shit for a minute, but like as far as like just us. Collabing is nothing. We don't have the same like mindset.
Okay.
Like at least from what I'm hearing from what he's dropping lately. So I'm just like, it's cool, but nothing I would put myself on. If that makes sense.
Yeah,
so,
I feel it. I got you.
But yeah, other than that, it's just like, as far as Fairfield goes, I'm just trying to make it better when
got
I get
you.
To where I go. So this is so that. Because I just feel like here is really like, y'all, you know, the public school, the prison pipeline type of thing.
Yeah, definitely.
That's literally like this area for sure. If you're not going to the military or if you're not going to Solano, you're going to prison. Or you're going to work.
Or you doing some other
shit. Or you working for the rest of your life or become the bum / crackhead.
Definitely.
So it's like, I just want to change that. And it's like, we got so much shit going on. Like I said. We only have two middle schools, bro.
I mean, that's, yeah.
We have two middle schools, bro.
They keep closing down.
They closing middle schools. They closing, like, elementary schools and shit. Like, what is going on?
Yeah.
Dover getting changed to a regular elementary school.
JoJo goes to Dover.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, it's a regular elementary school. I'm like, what the fuck? They closed that shit before we could even go.
Yeah. Right
it's like,
before,
what the
year
fuck?
Before.
It's right around the corner. Like,
I know.
Why?
We had to go deep ass.
I know, now I gotta go to Sullivan now. Like
take this shit.
Yeah, so.
Damn.
It's just trash. Like, half. I just feel like it's a lot of things that a lot of artists, even if they're not from here, but just if you're from here and, like, if you're gonna be an artist and you say you're an artist and you care about, like, I feel like an artist cares about the people more than he does for himself because at the same time, you're putting yourself out there. You're giving as an artist. So I feel like if you're giving as an artist enough to put it in music, you should be able to give back to the community in order to build it up. But
right, Opine's here for the people.
That's right. You have any more questions?
No, nope, we're all set here. I think he ended it great off with his journey for the future here.
That was a nice.
So also, where can they find you at one more time?
You can find me. I have a website, opineismyname.com. you can find me on SoundCloud, just soundcloud.com/opine.
I'll have that shit down there too.
Follow me on Twitter and Instagram, _opineismyname_. And
get the followers up.
Yep.
And also follow Blackout's
music. Go check out his shit that he has right now. Yeah,
check me out on Apple Music as well. I'm trying to get some streams up on there. So Homicide Hood Rat on Apple Music, and I got some stuff coming for y'all this month.
Stay tuned for some new shit also. Right. Follow Black Alice everywhere.
Black Alice.
Stay tuned for some more shit.
We come with some shit. All right.
In your area. All right.